Here we have two plants, plant A and plant B. Plant A, plant B. When I buy plant A and plant B at the store, plant A is shorter than plant B by 1 inch. Do you see what's going on there? Plant B is this line. So plant B starts out twice as tall as plant A. But over a certain number of weeks, at some point, actually after exactly 2 weeks, they're the same height, which means that plant A is growing faster. It has a larger rate of change. And so let's just focus on plant A. I'm going to use this point. I can really use any point. See how that would be a fine point, that one, that one. I'm going to use a point way up here just so I have more to show my change in Y goes. It goes from 1 to 5. So for plant A, the delta Y will be an increase of 4 because I went from 1 to 5. So that's plus 4. Plus 4 what? Plus 4 inches. Over, going to the right 4, start at 0 weeks and I'm now at 4 weeks. So that's an increase of 4 weeks. And 4 divided by 4 is 1. So plant A is growing at a rate of 1 inch per week. 1 inch per week. Let me see if I can find that down here. There it is. Plant B, grab the same color. Bad choice. Let's grab green. Plant B, let's use the same. Oh, no, sorry, I almost messed up. I'm looking at plant A. Plant B, this from this point to, see, there's some bad choices. You want one where it intersects, like an X and Y that are whole number values, ideally. So I'm going to go from, first let me erase the thing that could create confusion. I'm going from this point to this point. So my delta Y, I'm going from 2 inches to 4 inches, so that's a delta Y of plus 2. Positive 2 inches. And then my delta X is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 weeks. So 2 divided by 4 is 1 half. But I see, when I look at these, I see it right here actually. I see they're representing these rates as decimals. Now, we wouldn't, let me not say that yet. Let me just say that 2/4 is 1/2 and 1/2 is 0.5. So 0.5 inches per week. 0.5 inches per week. So we'll cross that one off. By the way, this is why, even though plant B is twice as tall when you buy it, after only 2 weeks, they're the same size because plant A is growing twice. It's got twice the rate of growth as plant B. It's kind of important to talk about if you have context like this with units and you're quantifying a rate of change in like a real world scenario like this, then sometimes you would express that rate as in standard form as a decimal. If we had no context, if we were simply plotting points on a coordinate plane with no units, then what I said before holds about you would want your slope to be represented as a ratio and leave it in fraction form. I just want to mention that so that doesn't cause any confusion.